gives me great pleasure to welcome you to the inauguration of the Islam in Africa organization. For many centuries, Muslims bore the touch of civilization in Africa. They spread literacy and knowledge, developed centers of learning of international repute, built states of varying complexities, and achieved such standards of justice and equity, surpassing that of many a contemporary African state. But since the colonial times, Muslims in Africa have been divided by and confined within boundaries drawn by European imperialism. Within these boundaries, our way of life as Muslims became increasingly supplanted, and we became gradually elbowed out, and consequently were unable to exert the influence our number warrants. We lacked even the forum to discuss our problems and coordinate our efforts. In the circumstances, our voice became feeble, our efforts dissipated, and our progress as Muslims became severely curtailed. Efforts of our brothers from outside Africa has certainly had some positive impact. But the real progress of Islam and Muslims in Africa lies in the ability of African Muslims ourselves to take charge of our destiny. The Islam in Africa organization is actually born out of this realization, and by providing Muslims in Africa with a forum to address themselves to the issues facing Islam and Muslims in Africa, it represents a watershed. So as we inaugurate the organization today, we are actually at the threshold of history. We wish to herald a new era in which Muslims will reunite, strengthen their bonds of brotherhood, enhance their solidarity, close their ranks, pool their resources together, and once again play the role they have always played in Africa. It is particularly significant that this event is taking place at a time when the winds of change are sweeping across the continent, giving this organization an opportunity to direct the efforts of Muslims in participating effectively in process of change at both the national and continental level. We, the Muslims in Africa, must see it as our primary responsibility and must not expect someone else to do it for us. We must muster all it takes to surmount whatever difficulties that might be ahead. Those of us in Nigeria are quite aware of the goodwill extended to us by choosing Nigeria as the headquarters of the Islam in Africa organization. We shall endeavor to do our best, but we need your patience and understanding. Above all, we need Allah's guidance and support. We have placed our greatest hope in His promise, for in the Quran, the Almighty said, and I quote, "And those who strive in our cause, we will certainly guide them to our path. For verily, Allah is with those who do the right, who do right." We further pray to Him, "Our Lord, power out constancy on us and make our steps firm. Help us against those that reject faith." Assalamu alaikum.
Assalamu alaikum. I am Shehu, that is Usman, that's his name, Musa Eradua. I'm a retired soldier. Well, I did my secondary school in Katsina, got trained in Sandhurst, got commissioned in the Nigerian Army. At one time I was, when Usman was governor of Kaduna State, I was the chief of staff, Supreme Headquarters. And I retired from the army in 1979, and I'm now a peasant farmer
We start by cooperating and learning also, because some of the agencies are older than us and they have already been in the field. We are not in competition with Islamic agencies. Our main job is to not only to complement them, but also to try to coordinate the work. So we are not in competition. We will never be in competition with any Islamic organization. And for now, the relief organizations that are already on the ground, we are not only just cooperating with them, we are also learning from them how best to do it. And when we go and start doing it ourselves, we will only be complementing what they are already doing. We are not going to do it in competition with them or against them. No. So for now, we are cooperating with the present existing organizations.
The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was said with a Quran, that was money. And he didn't have it. When he said that, he didn't have it at the end of his message. When he said he has completed his message to us, he didn't have money. He came with the Quran, he left us with the Quran. That is our heritage. And ladies and gentlemen, I submit to you that we keep this heritage. There is nothing that is beyond us. Nothing that we cannot surmount. Nothing that we cannot cover. And I think we should hold this and keep this in our mind. Forget about being materially poor. And think of our spiritual strengths. If we do, I think we are about to start our march in changing this corrupt world and giving strength for the world is today looking for an alternative. The alternative is the truth. The only truth is the Quran. My brothers and sisters, I think I will stop here. May Allah in His infinite mercy grant us the strength, the understanding, to follow the path of truth and to also have the strength to do what is our principal duty as Muslims, to teach others this path of truth and to unite not only ourselves but to unite others. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.